Thank you, Mr. Mayor and honorable city council. My name is Alan Hoffa. I am here to speak about agenda item 11A, and thank you for the opportunity to do that. One of the things that, as you know, Seaside is so well known for is being a leader in civil rights. I so much appreciate as a neighbor and as a friend from neighboring Monterey, the way that you provide leadership with the Martin Luther King Jr. March, with the naming of Along the Way, and in so many other ways, with standing up for those who are dispossessed and those who are in need of support. So I want to let you know that I very much stand with you as you consider this. I realize it's a difficult political decision, but your leadership tonight will make it easier for me to provide similar direction in the city of Monterey, and I really hope you give it careful consideration.
Everyone, I'm Mary Smith, and I want to address the agenda item 11A as well. I want to ask the city if they would consider and put it on the agenda. And I would like this city to seriously consider making this city a sanctuary city and putting it in an ordinance, not just saying that we won't cooperate. And also with the police department, I would like to say that I'd like for this city that I've been born and raised in to not cooperate with ICE. And I think that is a very important thing that our city stand together. Right now, the stores, if you drive up Broadway, you'll see stores closed down. Grocery stores, major grocery stores in our city is closed down because immigrants are threatened and they're scared. And they've closed down to protest. And I think that we need to stand behind the people in our community to help build our community and to help support our community who pays taxes here in our community. And we need to stand behind the people that live here in our community and keep our community together and not divide our community. So I want to request that you put this sanctuary city issue on the agenda and that you prepare to write an ordinance and for sanctuary cities in Seaside, California.
Good evening. My name is Alicia Ryburn. I was born and raised in Seaside. I'm very proud of it. One of the things I love about Seaside is its diversity, and I too would like to strongly urge you all to consider writing an ordinance on sanctuary cities for Seaside specifically. And I would love to see Seaside lead the way in this county. I know that the county supervisors just passed a resolution saying that Monterey County would be a welcoming county, but that doesn't necessarily mean specifically that no federal funds are going to be used. They just said the wording is we urge local offices not to use federal funds. It doesn't actually, there's no teeth to that. And I would love to see the Seaside City Council write an ordinance in protecting our immigrant and refugee brothers and sisters, because we know that cities and counties and states that become sanctuary cities, we know that they have lower instances of crime, they have higher employment, and their economies prevail. Please consider writing an ordinance for Seaside Sanctuary City. Thank you.
So, Gertrude Smith, Birch Avenue, Seaside. Y'all know me. I first would like to say thank you to Councilor Jones for requesting this item to be considered. I really appreciate it, and I would like to say that I'm proud of you as a fellow young Pan-African woman for pushing forward for what you believe in. I know that the affirmation is not always there, and I just want to say that I appreciate you. And so with that being said, I think that this is something that definitely needs to be done, because we are a majority-minority city, and that's something that, shouldn't be taken lightly, and we have to take the measures necessary to protect our residents.
Hello, Maxwell Green. I'm one of your Monterey neighbors, and I really do hope you consider putting 11A on the agenda and making Seaside a sanctuary city. And I certainly hope my city of Monterey can do the same and the county, because, well, we're bound by principle. People give you many intimidation arguments about convenience when it comes to what the federal government may or may not do, but principle is what you got to stand with. And you got an obligation, because these ice raids, what happened, it's not pretty. Families get broken up, and there are many details we get to, which are just really not pretty, and we really have an obligation to stand up and protect those people. And I really hope you folks do so.
Good evening, Council and Mayor. I'm here. My name is Yaneli Martinez, Council Member for the City of Greenfield. And I'm here to support Councilmember Jones, likewise like many other people here. I applaud trying to bring the sanctuary city to Seaside. It is much needed. As you could tell, I work as a teacher in a school, and it's horrible to hear kids cry, argue about their parents might not being there that after school the next day. It's a horrible thought, and I applaud you, and I hope you do put this as an ordinance and the rest of the cities could follow, because this is something that would ease so many people's fears, pain, and just thinking about the human part of it. It's awesome, and I applaud you. And once again, I'm here to support, and hopefully you guys do bring it as an ordinance. Thank you.
Good evening, Mayor and City Council. My name is Sam Rush, and I work as an economic development consultant. I'd like to talk about the same topic, the immigration topic, on a national and local level, a little bit different viewpoint of it. I'm doing a lot of work in San Mateo County, and I like where they're going in this direction. They're saying, they're really focusing on the asset of the immigrant workforce coming into their community. They have a lot of highly educated, skilled people, and they're focusing on that and saying, we're a welcoming city, they're part of our economy. We have the same thing in Seaside. One of the best things about Seaside is it's a diverse city, and it's going to stay diverse, and it's welcoming. You can walk down the street and get a job, or you can walk down the street, you know, with prayer beads. No one will care. They'll welcome you as a business person and as a customer. So we have that here. I went to Congressman Panetta's town hall. It was very good. One of the things I've seen a lot of the local agencies missing is you'll hear it over and over at these big meetings is when you get in trouble, call a lawyer. I can tell you two things. I used to work with Councilmember Hoffa in the planning department, the Housing and Property Management Department. We had a lot of Hispanic and immigrant people come to that office. They didn't know how to call a lawyer. They didn't have money to call a lawyer. You know, and it's a very big barrier, that alone. What I did tell them is if you get in trouble, at least go to a government agency, ask somebody bilingual to speak your language for help, and they'll get it started. What I'd like to see in Seaside, once again, roll out the welcome mat and have a designated staff person that somebody can call. Number two, one thing that they did do right at the Panetta Town Hall was they passed out cards explaining people's rights. Once again, it would be even better if you in Seaside had a business card with maybe some nonprofit attorneys and different people like that that they could keep with them, because once they get in trouble, it's too late. Finally, many of you know me from the cannabis business and that policy that's coming through, and this is almost the exact same thing because it's federally illegal, but on a local level, we can make change. The cannabis business, the cannabis policy, the cannabis laws all started on a local level and changed before federal law did. That's what we're dealing with here. What I tell those young people, and I'm going to say this to everyone in the room, number one, have leadership and join the community. Join the PTA, join the Chamber of Commerce. Don't be silent. Number two, don't get in trouble. Just don't get in trouble. Pay your taxes. Pay your car tax. Don't disturb the peace. Don't do the three Ds. DUI, disturbing the peace. Forget the third one, it's a big one too, so don't do anything. Domestic violence. For the love of God, no domestic violence, because in the cannabis business, the wife will say, and he's got a farm in the backyard. And so really, let's band together, and as a community, we can take a leadership position here in Seaside. No, we can. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Hello, good evening, everyone. My name is Sandoval Diaz, and I'm a resident of Seaside. I've been a resident for 17 years now, I believe. I know I went to Seaside High School. I recognize Mr. Dennis Alexander. And I also recognize Ralph Rubio because I was the one who organized the march back in 2005, and you gave me a recognition for being the youngest activist in the city of Seaside in the first march that was taking place. I know I have stayed quiet for a long time, but I think it's time for me to come back. And I really want you to carry on 11A to make Seaside a sanctuary city. I love the diversity that we have here in Seaside. I love how people really are to help each other. They do help each other. And I know that there's a lot of kids that are very scared now because of all of this that's going on. I ask you guys that you guys support us on this, as you guys ask for the Latino vote, when you guys go door by door knocking, so we can vote for you guys and you guys can represent us, because this is what you guys do, you guys represent us. And I want to be represented. I want you guys to make Seaside a sanctuary city for my community, because I want kids to not live their lives by fearing that their parents are not gonna be here. If their parents are not here, what are those kids gonna do? You know, we need parents to educate their children. We need parents to be here for their kids so we can stop the violence. Violence generates violence. We want parents to be able to raise their kids. And most of all, we want Seaside to continue to be that city of diversity. That we are not really, okay, what are you? What's your race? No, we're just one, because we're human beings. And this is why I love Seaside, and this is why I love staying here, and this is why I'm attending college here, and this is why I'm planning to transfer to CSU and be here, because I love this area, and I want this area to continue to be a city of immigrants, a city of diversity. And as I ask for you guys to really consider this, as you guys ask us, to both, you know, like for you guys to represent us, this is the best way that you guys can represent a city who the minority is the majority in this city. Thank you.
Paul Wolf, Seaside resident, and yes, I work in the schools, and I can also testify that there are many of my students who are afraid, although they often joke about it. That's the way they deal with these kinds of things, through humor. But they're definitely, it has clouded their minds, or many of their minds. If you caught the news this afternoon, you will have heard that the Trump administration has rescinded the travel ban and won't pursue the same piece of legislation in the next level for the court battle. They may rewrite it in some fashion. To my knowledge, that is the first time I can ever think of our new president relenting on anything. When he does something, he just goes all the way with it, whether it's rational or not, supported or not. His desire was to consolidate everything into his own power, meaning intelligence, judicial, other politicians, and so on. And so what we have seen there with the judicial branch standing firm about the travel ban is that is a form of our checks and balances. And one of the overlooked forms of checks and balances we have is the federal system versus the state system and the local system. That is very important. So if it's federal government versus local government, the federal government takes precedence. But if you take literally thousands of municipalities in our country, all of taking a moral stand on this, then you have something very powerful. So the question isn't just, what is your relationship with us and how do we feel? How are you reaching out to other municipalities and saying, we are taking a moral stand against what's going on, against the Trump administration? Because 3 or 4 weeks into this administration, we know that this may not be the first and only moral stand that we're going to have to take. So are you preparing for that? Are you ready for that? Because there's a lot more to come, and maybe you have to prepare for the worst and hope for the best. But I think that's the reality that we face. Thank you.
Good evening, Mr. Mayor, council members. Thank you for hearing us tonight. My name is Howard Scher. I'm here to speak in favor also of I first came to Seaside just about 20 years ago in 1997 when I was at the Defense Language Institute. And when I left the Army, my wife and I liked it so much that we stayed. And we've been proud of Peninsula residents for about 20 years now. I'm a citizen. I'm an American citizen. I'm making an assumption, assuming that all members of the council are citizens as well. And I want to speak as a citizen to other citizens. Fear. People huddled in churches, afraid of the police. People crossing the Canadian border through the snow with their families, with their small children, because of fear. Is that who we are? Is that who we are now? Are we really that kind of country? Is that who we've become? I don't think so. And I don't think, with due respect, I don't think the members of the council think so either. Declaring Seaside as a sanctuary city would be an incredibly strong statement to make. What kind of country we want, what kind of Americans we are. And I hope very, very deeply that you will put the item on the agenda and vote to provide sanctuary to undocumented Americans, future Americans, people who want to grow this city, this county, this state, this nation.
Good evening, Mayor, City Council. My name is Sergio Rangel, President of United Local 43 Tamil Workers Union. Also, Seaside resident for 21 years. So I ask you as a City Council and a person that made rules for this beautiful city. And thank you so much because our city is getting safe. And it is what we want to see, right? Right now, we suffer regarding about immigration here and there in this great, beautiful country. We are immigrants from all around the world. We come over here just to work, to do our job, to secure our family, to buy houses, and help this community to be better, help our country to be the best, and live with humanity, right? And we ask you, on this moment, it's a very critical situation. We don't know, what will happen. I'm not American citizen. I follow the rules. Yeah, we want that. But also, we want the cities to do the right thing, right? Now, ICE is persecuting our people here in Seaside, everywhere. And this is the moment to stop that. Because these people come to work. They don't come to do anything else. They just want to help the family. If someone made you break the law, okay, we understand that, right? But we are here to make America great again, not hate again, like Donald Trump is doing right now. Thank you so much. And I would like Seaside to be, a place, a sanctuary that everybody can live, with harmony. And I go forward with that. Thank you so much. And put in your agenda next time. We'll be here. Thank you so much.
Good evening, Mayor and City Council. Again, my name is Hector Aspilcueta, and I'm the Secretary Treasurer of Local 43. We represent 1,200 members in this Warren County. And more than 50% of our members were born outside the United States. And they work every day hard to make sure that their families have a place to live, have something to eat, and they actually can send them to school. Many of them live in this city. One of the things that it has been said, it is that illegals are criminals. Well, first of all, we are not illegals, we are undocumented, and we are human beings. Two, fear is not going to divide us. When they start telling me that my brother or my sister is a criminal, I'm not going to follow their what they are saying. I'm going to think by myself if this person is really a criminal or not. I'm not going to be watching Fox News to get my news. I'm going to go be out there reading and talking to people, talking to leaders like you, to understand what really is a community. I'm really saddened to hear these voices coming out and start spreading fear among our community. Our kids, 10, 5, 6 years old, are the ones who are afraid that the day tomorrow, many of them are going to be separated from their parents. So instead of saying to kids, be afraid, please do the other thing. Tell them, look, let's unite. Let's work together. There is no major goal that we have that to work in this country so we all can grow. We all can become better. So I hope that you can consider to have the civil society to become a sanctuary city. And we are not criminals. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Alexandra Burke. I absolutely agree, and I'm super thrilled to see you at the Kia. I'm here to support also the sanctuary city, and to build on it, I would love to see this year Seaside actually building on, celebrating, and investing in the diversity and the culture we have in Seaside. The diversity has always been our strength, and I imagine Seaside being the cultural hub of the Monterey Bay. More, you know, murals, more festivals, cultural events, festivals, religious events, open houses, things like that. You know, you have the Mission District in San Francisco, you have the Arts District, Olvera Street in Los Angeles. So I think we can use this kind of moment of chaos to really celebrate what we do have. And I don't want to kick a dead horse or anything, but one of my main problems with the Monterey Downs thing was that we're putting all of our investment way out there in Fort Ord. And when people visit Seaside, they're not going to know out there that Martin Luther King Jr. walked those streets. They're not going to know that, you know, they can get the best torta in the Monterey Bay on Broadway at La Tortuga, if any of you didn't know that. So we need to be investing right here, Broadway, Fremont. Let's really make that happen this year. On this agenda, there's like 80,000 to this, 27,000 to that. I'd really like to see this year some money and investment going into celebrating the culture and diversity of Seaside. Thanks.
Sue Hawthorne, Seaside. What's occurring to me right now is just a bunch of cliches, but sometimes cliches are useful. Sometimes somebody has already said something better than I can rephrase it. So, for starters, the only thing we have to fear is fear itself.
Yes.
What is happening in the federal government right now is absolutely shocking to me. It's unprecedented. It makes me afraid. I'm fighting against that, but it makes me afraid. And it makes me afraid for those who are vulnerable. Second cliche, we are stronger together than we are apart. When I was doing precinct walking in the last election, every member standing for the council was a registered Democrat. I'm very proud of that. I'm very proud of the fact that we have a diverse city, but our differences are not large. We are cohesive, we can hang together, we should pull together in these stressful times. Also, it's the worst thing to feel helpless. That is the worst stressor, and everybody knows that stress kills. The greatest stressor is feeling that you are in a situation over which you have no control. So bringing 11A back to the agenda as something that can be deliberated upon would at least give people the feeling that maybe there is something they can do about one of the things that threatens to go terribly wrong in this country. So I know that there is the threat of withholding federal funds, although our president seems daily to flout the law and feel that he is above the law. Indeed, he is not above the law, and I think that that is an empty threat. I don't think he has the ability to withhold federal funding, especially if enough people band together and say, no, we won't stand for this, we won't stand for that threat, which brings me to the final cliche, which is, let's stand up to the bully.
Hi, I'm Wes Wright, Salinas resident. But I just want to come out in support of 11A, obviously. It's time to just start maturing as a country, I think, and standing up for people. I mean, that's what democracy is supposed to be about. Legal, illegal, most people come in on a visa and just expire their stay, and you know, the paperwork is crazy, so there's no way anybody's going to make that in time. So people overstay. I mean, what's the big deal? They're still paying their taxes. We had amnesty in 87 or something like that. We should do that again. 361 people were deported out of the jail today, yesterday, sometime recent. And I guess what I'm getting at is with the Salinas, they say they want to do a immigration reform. That's what they passed. So it's really easy. You could copy that if you just needed something to say you're supportive. And it wouldn't affect any kind of federal funds, but that's where you really need to be at, is saying no. I mean, look at California's got a pot tax, man. Monterey County's got one. You guys should probably do one, too. It's lucrative. It's expensive. So you don't even really have to worry about federal funding. You guys are independently wealthy just off a pot. Another thing with immigration, you know, the Muslim ban, we're talking about discrimination, and there's a lot of discrimination with homeless people. There's a lot of discrimination in the way that our policies and procedures are transparent or lack of with police contact and the way that they the whole policies and procedures need to change. I mean, Sean Ault was shot in 30 seconds. Luke Smith shortly after, there was a boy. Got shot with a knife 8 times, which means they emptied their clips, the whole first line of officers. It's just a knee-jerk reaction, and we need to start changing the way that we deal with people. I mean, a lot of these things are social issues. When law enforcement comes, it's to enforce justice, supposedly, enforce the law, or at least as they see it. Sometimes they skip it because they have to follow orders. But policies and procedures, you know, we've got ICE here, and we have this Why You Stop Me program, and these things are geared toward having a submissive citizenry and not an informed citizenry and not even allow us to be a part of the process. You know, we need a lot more sunshine going on and a lot more interaction, which definitely goes to the point of the youth council. We need to be teaching our kids early. We need to be role modeling the behavior we want to see in those kids. So that's why you need to support 11A. And go ahead.
Thank you. Again, my name is Juan Martinez. You know, hearing all the different stories about the immigrants and stuff, I think about the Salinas Valley where I'm from. And I often wonder, you know, how does all these people know there's all these available jobs down here in summertime and that? And of course, we have history of migration back and forth ever since, you know, time in our memory. So we've been going across this so-called border for a long, long time, and we're never really able to do that. But one of the things that I have noticed is that every time you go and start a war, like in El Salvador, what happens, you get a bunch of people from El Salvador down here. But it's in Nicaragua, a lot of people from Nicaragua. When you get a war going on in Vietnam, a bunch of Vietnamese come over, and on, you know, we stick our nose oftentimes where we don't belong, cause a lot of trouble, take out as much nature or mineral rights and everything else we can get out of those countries. And what happens to the people? They're in turmoil, they're fighting amongst themselves, and where do they flee to? The ones with the money and without the money? Where do they come? The United States. Why? Bring me your tired, bring me your hungry, bring me your humbled masses. You know, all we're asking here is to support the Lady of Liberty and stand up for her, which she's saying, you know? That's all we're asking. Thank you.
I'm George Riley, not from your city.
this is the only city that has the credibility and the standing to make this kind of decision. This peninsula can stand up on principle for the entire peninsula if the city decides to act on this. I just encourage you to do that. Thank you.
Good evening. Kenneth Murray, 635 Charles Avenue, Seaside, California, pastor of Ocean View Baptist Church, 1200 Amador Avenue. As I listen to the majority of the public comments regarding Seaside becoming a sanctuary city, mine goes back years ago as a child through the civil rights movement and everything. And what our forefathers and foreparents stood for and fought for, and to have one person in authority come in and try to take that away from people, from human beings, regardless of being legal or illegal. We're all God's children. And so I look at it in a standpoint like as that, and then I look at it from the standpoint of our churches having a relationship with the Spanish pastors and their churches that utilize some of our sanctuaries. And majority of the times of their worship is centered around their people that have to work on Sundays, and they come in and they hold services in the late afternoon hour, or sometimes twice on Sundays, and during the week also, so that their members can have an opportunity to worship. And some of those members are legal or illegal, but God looks at us as children, and we're all imperfect in His sight. We're only made perfect by one way, that's by accepting Jesus. Don't mean to preach, but when you use that word sanctuary, that's where we gather. I support this idea. The Seaside Minister Alliance supported. And if I would have known that it was going to be on the agenda, or if I had checked the agenda like I normally do to find out, we would have had some of the Spanish pastors here also to support this and talk on this. And we do request that this be made an item on the agenda in the future. Thank you.
I'm sorry, I don't have a question about the budget. I just want you guys to acknowledge, and I want to acknowledge all the people that came here a little bit late for Proposition 11A so it can be carried out on the agenda to make Seaside a sanctuary city. I know I already spoke, but I just don't want them to, you know, be ignored. I wouldn't want to keep them hostage. So I just want you guys to see that a lot of people came here, even though they came a little late. I really appreciate that, and we're like really hoping for you guys to vote to make Seaside a sanctuary city. Okay? I know, I understand. I just wanted to acknowledge that. Thank you.
Thank you. Hello, Council, Mayor. My name is Ryan Gibson, Seaside City resident. I want to speak on 11A tonight on regards to adding the sanctuary city to our agenda. I believe it's nothing less than an obligation to tell our residents that we are with them, that no matter what the federal government says, that we are supporting our residents here tonight, that they are our priority as a whole, and I would swear that you do. Thank you.
Seeing no other public comment, we'll go ahead and close public comment this time. And thank you, everybody, for your passion. And Mr. Roland, Ms. Jones and I are working on the youth council.
And I follow you.
As soon as we get it up and running. We won't comment on what's not on the agenda yet. So the next item is public agency communication.